Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. On today's episode, let's look at how you can use functions like page up, page down, home, and end, even if you're working on a MacBook that doesn't have these keys on the keyboard. Now, if you've used an older computer, or maybe you have the current Mac extended keyboard for a desktop machine, there are some keys on the right, page up, page down, home, and end, that you may use a lot. For instance, page down will take me through the different pages one at a time of this pages document. And page up, likewise, end will take me all the way to the end, and home will take me all the way to the beginning. These are very useful keys, but you won't find them on the wireless keyboard, and you won't find them on any MacBook, which make up a majority of Macs sold today. So what do? There is an alternative. You can actually access the functionality of these keys even if the keys aren't on your keyboard. So the thing to do is look for the FN key. This is usually on a MacBook at the lower left hand corner. On some other keyboards and older keyboards it's sometimes near the upper right. But it has just the letters F and N on it, standing for function. And you can use these to alter the arrow keys to perform these functions. So for instance, if you want to do page down, use FN and the down key. And likewise, FN and the up key will go back up. If you want to do home, FN and left will do it, and FN and right will do end. Same exact functionality as page up, page down, home, and end, but without actually having those keys on your keyboard. Now if you're using Safari at the moment and you're not anywhere where entering a space is going to do something else. For instance, if I was typing in a field, then a space would give me a space character. If I had my cursor over this video, a space would start it. But if I have my cursor somewhere else, over some uneditable text or the background, I can use the space bar to page down and shift space bar to page up. This only works if the space won't do any other function when you're viewing something in Safari. Now usually with the home, end, page up, page down keys, there's a forward delete key. And this deletes in the opposite direction from regular delete key. So I'm going to put the cursor right here. And if I hit delete, of course, it deletes back. I can delete forward using the FN key and the delete key. And you can see it deletes the character in front. It's the same as using that forward delete key on an extended or older keyboard. Now home and end, or FN left and FN right, will actually move your view, but it won't move the cursor. So for instance, if I were to scroll down, put my cursor here at the end of this paragraph, and then do FN left, it takes me to the beginning of the document, but the cursor isn't there. And if I were to actually insert a space at this point, you could see it jumps down to where the cursor was. That's because it doesn't move the cursor. But you can actually move the cursor using other keys. You can do command up and command down. Command up looks like it works just like the home button or FN left, but the difference is that the cursor is now there at the beginning. Likewise, command down will look like it works like an end or FN right, but it puts the cursor there at the end. Now there is something that does the opposite of this. If I put my cursor somewhere here in the middle of the document and then say I'm scrolling and looking at something else and I've lost my cursor and I want to know where it is, a lot of people will hit the space bar to insert a space. It jumps to there and then you delete the space. But you can do that without inserting a character like that. You can do control, not command, but control L, and it will actually take you to where your cursor is. It puts the cursor actually as close as it can to the middle of the screen.